for our beneficiaries. And I think as fundraisers, we all have a story or a moment when we remember and recognise why we do what we do. And I thought maybe just a little story, one of my stories, would be helpful to just remind us of why we do what we do. And you will each have your own, because they happen all the time, and when they do, they're fab. And I was at the London to Brighton, which is the British Heart Foundation's biggest event, sorry, shameless plug. So about 12,000 cyclists cycle from Clapham Common down to Brighton on Sunday. It's usually Father's Day, which makes some people very cross. Anyway, so 14,000 of them. I'm at the end leading the medal team. So we have to put a medal over every single one of these guys' heads. So they've got cycling helmets on, they're sweaty, they've just cycled for hours, and we kind of, but you know what, it's the most amazing thing to do. But the guys who come over the line, there are three groups. There's the whizzers, there's the blaggers, and there's the trusters. Now the whizzers are the guys who belong to cycling clubs, and they pay their registration fee, they probably won't do too much fundraising, but they love what they do, and they rush through, and they want their medal. But you know, maybe they like the British Heart Foundation, questionable. The blaggers are the people who kind of join halfway down, and sometimes they can be very professional cycling clubs, and they bang through the end and kind of knock you over and are horrible. There's people on old sort of cycles who clearly come from the shops. Who kind of push on through and say, well, could I have a medal? And it's very easy to recognise when they haven't done any fundraising because they haven't got a badge, they haven't got a number, and so we can like to say no and try and keep doing that. And try and get some money out of them. But the ones I want to focus on are the trustees. You can see the trustees coming from a long way off. And you guys will have had huge experience of this. They are the ones who have a name on their chest, who are crying, who have done it for 30 years, man and boy. Some fellow with his wife, literally, have been doing it for 30 years, and they came over the line, and the first thing they wanted to do was tell me the story of why they do it. And there is always a story. It's for a granny, it's for a daughter, it's for a husband, a son. And sometimes they're wonderful stories, and sometimes they're heartbreaking stories. And I've heard loads of those. Two or three Sundays ago, one of the hottest Sundays in the year, sunburned ear, putting medals on for 6 hours. But you know what? It was fantastic. That's why we do what we do, because those people care about us enough and their relatives to give us their hard-earned money. And that's why we're fundraisers, and that is what we are here to celebrate tonight, because you are fantastic.
Yeah. Some man, possibly from some thing, is beginning to talk at you quite loudly through some other things about some stuff. You're supposed to be able to listen. Some of you really realize just how staggeringly pissed you've become since the start of the dinner, or depending on who you work for, since lunch. Yes, you're in a nice venue, everything looks lovely, you're dressed in smart clothes. You might even be important. It is unlikely, but statistically you might. You'd be like that day, some of you are probably just one drink away from telling the sort of people who pop up in late night television documentaries about the police force. 9:15 on Monday, some of you, I mean, well done, frankly. You are the people, thank God for you, many hours from now will be dropped off who knows where, by a taxi cab, possibly licensed, probably not. And who knows who, wearing substantially fewer clothes or shoes, and about to embark on even if you know what, so disastrous and embarrassing for all concerned. People will still be discussing it next year's awards bash. Well, look, all I can say is I don't condemn or condone this behaviour, but if there is someone at your table who behaves like that, why not quietly, subtly take this opportunity to give them a little pat on the back?
Thank you.
seems to. Walking around London today, I've heard more than one person say, lock up your daughters. All those guys who regularly achieve excellence in fundraising and best practice in contraceptives and business. To the National Fundraising Awards 2017. This is the 27th National Fundraising Awards. I always think when the event has to be staged 27 times, it suggests it's definitely worth doing, or still yet to be got right. But let's see how we get on. I've been asked to remind you, I'm sure you already know, these are the only awards created by fundraisers for fundraisers. Which I think very nice to demonstrate. So try as you might, you simply can't stop fundraisers doing nice things for other people. Even for other fundraisers. You people are so delightful, you make me simultaneously ashamed and sick. What I tend to find about these things is the less I understand about the sector in question, the better the evening goes. Which means that right now we are in for an absolute belter. Luckily, I've got a sort of general award spiel. So, well done all of you for all your creativity, slash all your selling, slash all your manufacturing, slash for simply being you. It's been a happy about a year for advertising, slash off licenses, slash the entertainment industry, slash private quality. As I say, I really don't know much at all about the world of fundraising, but at the same time, what a fantastic year it's been.
The winner of the Best Legacy and Inbound campaign is Bernardo! Yeah!
Also can exude energy and longevity and a deep sense of belief that participation, contribution, effort is not wasted. And our recipient tonight, this person who I think, even when I look at it globally, is one of the most qualified people for this next award. Congratulations, you deserve it, and may you continue to contribute in wonderful ways for the rest of your life, and take a bow and feel happy that your colleagues and your peers recognize the immense contribution you've made over the years. Thank you.
And our honorary
Chair
of Fundraising, I'm delighted to announce that the winner of the Lifetime Contribution Award is Lyndall Starr. Yeah.
But it really is one of the best things in the world to have the respect of your peers, and that's what this award is about. Other people who spend their time fundraising, struggling with all the challenges and the difficulties and the rewards of what is an amazing profession. And to get those people to give you an honour is a very, very wonderful, a wonderful experience for me. I wish I could be with you all. But the blue seas of Corsica have called me, and my holiday was booked way before I knew. So the world of fundraising is about people. And if we look at the work that we all do, improving the planet, improving the lives of people on our planet, it is an honour for all of us to be able to make a real difference in the world. And that's what fundraising is for. I've been lucky enough and old enough to live to see apartheid destroyed by people power, to see amazing technological advances through science so people no longer need to die of HIV and AIDS. And I've seen all of us really understand the impact of some of the damage that we as people and some of the values of this world have affected the health of our planet. And I know the answer to all the problems that we face in this world are for us to remember our common humanity, and to use our skills as fundraisers to drive the good energy of that common humanity and for all of us earn honour in the world that we live in and that we have a responsibility to. So I hope you have a great night. I hope I'll be there next year and I'll be able to hand this award on to the next person lucky enough to get this award from the Institute of Fundraising, the Lifetime Achievement Award, which is a wonderful thing for anyone to have. And I thank all of you.